The beginning of part two starts off with a pretty happy moment again, where everything, you know, all the tribulations from the first one have ended up in everything being okay, and Bella's made the change into a vampire without a hitch, really. And it's really about, you know, the only worry is Bella, how she's going to behave as a vampire, if she's going to go crazy. Especially because she's probably stronger than all the Cullens put together at the beginning. And you find out very rapidly that she's very much in control of herself, and, you know, she kind of finds it even easier than anybody else when they've been turned into a vampire. So it's a very happy beginning. They can expect it to be a lot bigger. I mean, the story spans the globe and encompasses a huge amount more of the vampire world. Many, many different characters, many different, you know, showing how many different powers and abilities vampires can have. And also showing the fulfillment of Bella's character, which is hopefully going to be a powerful moment.